In this video, we are going to see about the Environment Protection Act 1986. This evolved in the conference named United Nations Conference on the Human Environment, which was held in Stockholm, that is Sweden, during the year 1972 actually. Actually, they had a discussion on world community, which later they discussed with the importance of environment. As a result, we got this act in India, the Environment Protection Act 1986, to implement and to safeguard, protect our environment. This got its president assent during 23rd May 1986, and it came into force during the year 1986. Actually, this is 34 years old act. Let me tell you why this act came, and to safeguard what type of stuff and from whom it should be safeguarded actually. Let me tell you, like as I told you earlier, any factory or premises, industrial units, company, any other places which is polluting a lot, which is harmful to the nearby houses or like other persons or environment. Like to protect, to safeguard, monitor, measure, to take samples and to report them, to appoint inspectors to inspect the particular premises or factory or industry which is polluting a lot, and to give a penalty, like giving a punishment, etc. It was been giving a lot of like sections to deal with these type of industries who are polluting a lot. This pollution actually comes from manufacturing of goods or like processing or packaging or storing or transport, or if any unexpected situation like accidents. So in this act we have other acts which explains about public servant in section 21 of Indian Penal Code Act 1860, and we have the explanation for section 94, search of place suspected to constrain stolen property, forged document, etc. is explained in CRPC 1973, and the definition of for government company is being explained in section 617 in the Companies Act 1956, where 51% of the paid up share capital will be of from the central government or state government, affiliated state or central government. It comes under the definition of government company. And following that, as we all know, Constitution of India 1950, particularly Part 3, Fundamental Rights, Article 21 speaks about the protection of life and personal liberty. These are the other acts which helps and explain more about this act. To know more about the penalty, section 15 explains about the penalty, where a maximum of imprisonment will be given, which may extend to 5 years, or fine, or fine which may extend to 1 lakh rupees, or with both it can be. If they are not like continuously they are doing the same, means it will be like additional fine will be given as 5,000 for each day. This will be the first stuff which will be given as a penalty. If they are continuing even for another 1 year, then they will be given a imprisonment for which may extend to 7 years of imprisonment. So from this act you can just get 7 years of imprisonment. So make sure you are being aware of this act. And moving on with the hierarchy, as usual, central government plays very important role, and following that in state wise we have boards and committees helping for this, and NEERI is the particularly NEERI helps in giving notice, like circulation, anything to be noticed to the particular industry or anything, they should respect and they need to cooperate according to this act. And following that, we have website like Central Pollution Control Board, and we have lot of State Pollution Control Board's website for each state. We have for each 29 states we have pollution control boards, as well for union territories as well. We do have state control committees So you can just go and see those like websites. And following that to a particular, we have Tamil Nadu Pollution Control Board, where you can see, for example, like Ambattur, like areas, there are a lot of industries. So following that, we have in Egmore, we have lot of environmental laboratories, advanced environmental laboratory, which help in control of these type industries. Following that, we have Section 5A, which explains about the appeal to National Green Tribunal Act 2010. So you can just read those section. And following that, Section 22 speaks about the bar of jurisdiction, where no civil court will be explained in it. So just see them. The National Green Tribunal's headquarters, like it is in New Delhi, and following that, we do have in Chennai as well, a southern zone. Following that, the definition for environment, it includes water, air, land, and the interrelationship which exists among and between water, air, land, and human beings, other living creatures, plants, microorganisms, and properties explained in definition 2A. Following that, we have 2B, environmental pollutant like solid, liquid, gaseous substance which is injurious to environment. It's explained in 2B. Following that, we have environmental pollution, handling, hazardous substance of occupier, and prescribe has been explained in 2A to 2G. You can just read out those section. And to complain, who can complain is like Section 19 explains about the cognizance of offences, where central government and the related affiliated authority, government can complain it. And following that, any person in B, it has been explained, any person can complain. Point is like 60 days of notice should be given, prescribed as per the act, alleged or on the intention based complaint, it will be checked on. And you can just move on to the central government or authority officer, as I told you earlier. Following that, to make lot of awareness among the citizen and to the people, we celebrate worldwide World Environment Day on every year on 5th June, as internationally it has been celebrated as a World Environment Day. Following that, in India particularly, we have a very famous judgment like M.C. Mehta versus Union of India, AAR 1992, SC 382 judgment has emphasized to give awareness in television, radio, cinema halls, and in any language, national language or any regional language, it should be given. And based on this, we have a compulsory subject as environment in school as well as college to give awareness to the future generation. So in this way, we are giving awareness to the people based on this act. So following that, as I told you earlier, this act has 4 chapters as well. It has 26 sections explaining about this. As I told you earlier, based on the criminal procedure code, any magistrate found or if he is feeling that it need to be searched, they can give a warrant to search. And not below the rank of constable, a person will come and examine, and he may inspect. So all the any person who is there in the premise should cooperate. If it is any accident, they should explain about what type of chemical was used to take preventive measures and to stop the accident. So to make sure everybody is aware, if you have industry or you're running a company or any factory, you should be aware of this, and you should cooperate to the authority, concerned authority, who is coming and asking you to check or to take samples. You should cooperate with them. It may be any director or manager, or can be a secretary, or anyone in the premises, or any official or any employee who is there, should cooperate to the authority to take proper measures.